He was the first airbending master in over 100 years. Let's dive into Tenzin's bending evolution and break down the son of Avatar Aang. As we study Tenzin, we will be breaking down not just how he became a master, but how he ushered in a new generation of airbenders. First, we need to go all the way back to his childhood years. Besides Aang, Tenzin was the only airbender in the world. He felt immense pressure to keep the Air Nation culture alive, which was a lot of responsibility at a young age. Aang was only 12 years old when he became an airbending master. Tenzin, on the other hand, was pushing 17 and hadn't received his tattoos. He was an extremely skilled airbender, but he still had a lot to learn. Tenzin found himself getting into trouble as a teenager, sometimes even using his airbending to attack an opponent instead of self-defense. As an airmaster and the Avatar, Aang taught Tenzin about peaceful conflict resolution and to only use his bending for necessary defense. One of many lessons Aang gave on how to be a true air nomad. It was a lot of pressure for a teenager, but Tenzin was determined to uphold his father's legacy. Tenzin learned everything he could from his father, and his extensive training would pay off. He inherited all of his father's skills, like taking Aang's famous air scooter and turning it into a giant air wheel. Tenzin also inherited Aang's agility and evasiveness, making him almost untouchable in combat. Just like his father, Tenzin worked his way up to becoming a full-fledged master. But when Aang passed away, Tenzin became the last airbender, marking his first real test as a master.
You are the son of Avatar Aang. You are the hope for future generations of airbenders. The fate of the world rests on your shoulders.
But he wouldn't be the last airbender for long, because Tenzin would start an entire family of airbenders.
Where are your brother and sister?
You can't catch me! I'm the greatest air skeeter of all time!
Milo!
Iki, Jinora, and Milo learned from the basic physical movements up to the advanced techniques like the air scooter and glider.
The key is to be like the leaf. Flow with the movement of the gates.
Jinora will demonstrate. Airbending is all about spiral movements. When you meet resistance, you must be able to switch direction at a moment's notice.
Tenzin also made sure his children were tapped into their spiritual sides. Meditation was a mandatory practice on Air Temple Island.
Look at Milo. He's able to meditate peacefully.
Actually, I think he's asleep.
What? Well, at least he has the relaxing part down.
But his children wouldn't be his only pupils. As the only air master in the world, he knew one day he would need to train the Avatar.
Look at you, so big and strong. You've grown into quite the young Avatar.
Master Tenzin, I'm so glad you're here. I can't wait to get started.
But being Korra's master wouldn't be easy, seeing as airbending would be the hardest element for her to learn.
The other elements came so easily to me, but every single time I've tried airbending, nothing.
That's perfectly all right. We just need to be patient. Often the element that's the most difficult for the Avatar to master is the one most opposite to the Avatar's personality. For Aang, it was earthbending.
And Korra's personality being polar opposite to Aang's didn't help either.
You must promise me that your teenage years won't be like this.
I will make no such promises.
But Tenzin's teachings would sink in as Korra's training clicked during the Equalist Uprising.
No!
Little did Tenzin know, he was about to inherit even more students.
Look!
I'm airbending.
After the events of harmonic convergence, the spiritual energy surrounding the world shifted. Dozens of non-benders began waking up with airbending abilities, including Tenzin's older brother, Bumi. This marked the beginning of the return of the Air Nation.
I know that none of you chose to become airbenders, but now you do have a choice. We can relocate you somewhere safe, or you can come with me to the Northern Air Temple to live in peace and train as air nomads.
I want to go with you.
Me too.
Count me in.
I want to go too.
I'll go too.
Me
it
too.
Sounds like
I want to go too.
We all want to go.
Tenzin had a tough time training the Avatar. So training a group of former non-benders wasn't going to be much easier.
Dawn Patrol! Everyone up! I'm going to break you down and build you back up.
I'm not sure I want to shave my head.
That's fine. Shaving your head is a personal choice.
Wait, what?
It's not hard if you concentrate. Get back up! What's the matter? You can't handle it, soldier?
Yeah. But just like Korra, Tenzin's training would click. His students worked together to save Jinora from the Bison Rustlers.
You got me. I give up.
You think you could kidnap Jinora and all these baby bisons?
Kai! That's enough. An airbender never attacks a defenseless opponent. But that was very good technique.
It was a difficult start for sure, but his students had made significant progress. However, not everyone was on board with rebuilding the Air Nation. As Tenzin and his family began to train the new benders, evil was brewing in the dark.
Good. The entire family is here.
Zaheer was a non-bender who spent his entire life studying the air nomad culture. So when he got his abilities, he immediately excelled in advanced airbending techniques.
I want Korra, and I'm tired of chasing her.
You're using us as leverage.
Yes.
I will never let you get to Korra.
Unfortunately, you don't have a choice.
Yes, I do.
For the first time in almost 200 years, two airbending masters would duke it out. Tenzin was a true master. He would have easily beaten Zaheer if the rest of the Red Lotus hadn't ganged up on him.
Give up. It's over.
As long as I'm breathing, it's not over.
Little did Tenzin know his teachings would pay off again, even when he and Korra were down and out. Jinora stepped up.
Hurry! Everyone form a circle. Follow me.
Jinora inherited all of Tenzin's skills and then some. Her power and determination under Tenzin made her an extremely powerful airbender. Tenzin anointed her as master and began the official rebuild of the Air Nation. Rebuilding the Air Nation was one of Tenzin's greatest accomplishments, as he spent his entire life trying to carry on his father's legacy. He always faced incredible pressure of being the last airbender and son of Avatar Aang. He was never able to match his father's spiritual connection, but that trait was passed down to Jinora. With the help of his children and Avatar Korra, Tenzin was able to not only uphold his father's legacy, but forged his own destiny.
I failed you. I am no spiritual leader, and I've let the world down.
I'll never be the man you were.
You are right. You are trying to hold on to a false perception of yourself. You are not me, and you should not be me. You are Tenzin.
I am not a reflection of my father. I am Tenzin. I am Tenzin.
That wraps up Tenzin's airbending evolution. Which bender should we break down next? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for all things Avatar.
Milo, no, that is not a toilet! Oh dear.